Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Sing we merrily unto God our helper. Make a cheerful noise unto the God of Jacob. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. He fed them also with the finest wheat flour, Alleluia, and with honey out of the stony rock has he satisfied them. Alleluia, Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God,
unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high,
and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee. We worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament has left unto us a memorial of thy passion, grant us, we beseech thee, so to venerate the sacred mysteries of the body, of thy body and blood, that we may always receive within ourselves the fruit of thy redemption, who livest and reignest with the Father, unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The reading is taken from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it, and said, This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do ye, as oft as ye drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The eyes of all wait upon thee, O Lord, and thou givest them their meat in due season. Thou openest thy hand and fillest all things living with plenteousness. Alleluia, alleluia. My flesh is meeting thee, and my blood is drinking thee. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me. Our hymn. hymn number 399. Alleluia, sing to Jesus.
Flesh and bread. drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he that eateth me, even he shall live because of me. This is that bread which came down from heaven, not as the fathers did eat and died. He that eateth of this bread shall live forever.
Receives its identity from the risen Christ, and it receives that identity day after day, week after week, in the central ritual of Christian belonging, the Eucharist, the Holy Mass. But the Eucharist can never, as Rowan Williams says, be cut off from the pattern of God's mission in the world. And so the Eucharist is the centre of the Church's life, in that it connects us with the energy of life that lives beyond our own resources, beyond what the mere eye can see. In the Eucharist, in the Holy Mass, in the body and blood of Christ, the Church celebrates a gift that it never possesses, but always receives anew, each time. We receive what we are as the Church, in order to become what we receive, the body of Christ, Corpus Christi. Because Christ's life is Catholic and unbounded, he is never fully absorbed or contained by any particular human context, or any particular human situations. The gift of himself, great things are given. The great things that Christ gives us and gives to the Church are given to the whole of humanity. Vladimir Losky argues, ecclesiology is derived from a vision of a redeemed humanity. The Church's own internal identity springs from its mission to embody a renewed creation, a world out there desperately in need transformation and renewing of hope, of direction. And the sacraments of the Church offer that, because the sacraments of the Church offer a common good. Whenever the Church becomes withdrawn and introspective, the confession of Christ withers. Great things are given because our own identity lies beyond ourselves. God still is in the world. God still loves the world. Sunday by Sunday in the Holy Mass we proclaim that, so that every act of receiving the Eucharist enacts the Catholicity of Christ and the expansiveness of a community that makes room for the whole world of human experience. It's not just my thing. It's not an exclusive club. And so, as ever, this mysterious God hides himself, as it were, in bread and wine, and very characteristically speaks almost crudely about it. Eat me, drink me. A servanthood incarnation. And so the sacraments speak as God speaks, of humility, of disposition, of transparency, of divine self-giving. There's a deep sense then that the Eucharist both stabilizes and destabilizes. In the Eucharist, stability is brought about by God's recalling his people to know about the transforming power of the cross Yet there is also a destabilizing power here. To be opened out repeatedly and open to repeatedly Christ's past is to be opened out to a future anticipated by him, and thus to be incorporated into a forward momentum of the Holy Spirit, which activates in us an increased longing to be the instruments of God's love for his creation. The Church has a role to play now as ever, never before, certainly in my lifetime. And so every Eucharist celebrates a form of letting go, relinquishing the idea that we own Christ. To receive the sacrament, then, is to receive Christ in empty hands. We don't come to the Eucharist clutching all our agendas. We discover Christ's gift and our own poverty at one and the same time. That is the meaning of Christian mission. That is the gift of the sacraments. At the table, at the altar of God, daily, weekly, we find that Christ is already there ahead of us. We don't bring him, as it were. Christ is there already ahead of us, offering food and drink to unworthy but most welcome guests. And our poverty as humanity is a hunger for Christ, whether he understands that, accepts that or not. For we can only be fully satisfied in a fully reconciled human belonging, which quite frankly does not yet exist in the world. And so we are reminded afresh through the sacraments that we, our mission, is to go out looking for Christ, crossing those barriers which are not always comfortable, and trying to undo those barriers the human being so comfortably erect. And we do that in our own personal surroundings as well. And so as followers of Christ on this path, we let go of all that we so easily hold sacred and cling to. The Eucharist is a tonic to remind us these are Christ's gifts, freely given. The Church then, in conclusion, exists not for itself, but for the sake of a reconciled humanity. We are, as Rowan Williams said, a laboratory of human possibility, human flourishing, human belonging. And our materials are not bombs and guns and all those things. Our materials are a book, a chalice, and the broken body of God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father
Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and of all things, visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and for all according to their needs. Almighty God, who has taught us to pray for all men and has promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in faith, we beseech thee to look mercifully upon thy universal church and to inspire it with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. We pray for the church, the work of the church, particularly in this hour. We pray especially for our diocese, for Joshua, our bishop-elect, for Tabu, our archbishop, for the archdeacons, the canons, the clergy, and all their families. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the needs of those who live in this place and worship in this church. We pray, God, that they may know your love, your presence, that through the sacraments they may know we are one. They are and continue to be the body of Christ at St. Michael and all the angels. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for a right stewardship of the world God has created. We pray for the nations of the world and for their leaders, especially at this time, that they may minister with justice for the maintenance of righteousness and peace. We pray for those elected to public office, both in our own land and throughout our continent, and in our world, as we say, God bless Africa,
God her children, guide her leaders, and give her peace. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
Beseech thee to bless both those whom we love and those for whom we are bound to pray. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We beseech thee of thy goodness to send thy healing grace to all who suffer in body or in soul. Think this morning particularly of those in our parish who are battling with ill health and often just feeling down. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend thy grace for keeping all those who have died in faith, especially mourning those whose hears mind occur this week. We pray, Lord, for the repose of the souls of Magdalena Miss Plum, Daisy Mullany, Norma Hart, John Dunn, priest whose hears mind is on the 15th. George Pundrian, Francis Lennox, Edward Jarvis, Vivian Bissett, whose year is mine, is on the 16th, Kenneth Schwartz, whose year is mine, is on the 17th, George von Scottbeck, priest, whose year is mine, is on the 19th, Arnold Foster, Helene Rodder, Maria McBride, Thomas Wardle, here's mine on the 20th. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual
shine upon them.
And we pray for those who will die in our city today, those who have died both of the virus or virus-related diseases and all other deaths. And we pray especially today for those who will die alone and unloved. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
As we join our prayer with the unending intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all the saints, we pray that we may be partakers with them of thy heavenly kingdom. Merciful Father, grant these our prayers for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Amen.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacredness, mystery, let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty. We confess
to God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed through our own grievous fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy upon us.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins, deliver you from all evil, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you unto everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The priests of the Lord shall be holy unto their God, for the offering of incense and the bread of their God do they offer. Therefore shall they be holy, and not profane the name of their God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Our offertory hymn number 400, Lord enthroned in heavenly splendor.
Thank you.
would accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should, at all times and in all places, give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, who, with thine only begotten Son and the Holy Ghost, art one God, one Lord, in Trinity of persons and in unity of substance, who hath created all things through thy eternal will. Therefore, with angel and archangel, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
All glory and thanksgiving be unto thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, and to suffer death upon the cross, who by his one oblation of himself, once offered, made a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and instituted, and in his holy gospel, commanded to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming in. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may we partake of his most blessed body, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take it, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance. This holy bread of eternal life. be humbly beseeching, pour thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these disciples, that all we who are partakers of this Holy Communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice, praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and in faith in his blood, we in all thy own church may obtain remission of our sins and all here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. And although we be unable, through our members, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept as our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offense, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
As our Savior Jesus Christ has commanded, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God,
that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace.
We do not presume
to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
This is the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his
supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
As oft as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Amen. give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious.
His mercy endures forever.
God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of the Lord, and the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.